It's cold and snowy outside, but it's warm and cozy inside the Ford Center in downtown Evansville, Indiana. And the Bradley Braves are in town to take on the Evansville Purple Aces. Good afternoon, Cole Carr alongside Preston Leinebach. And Preston, we're a month away from the NBC tournament. Somehow we're a month away, but two teams trying to get things going in the right direction for that tournament.
Yeah, I'm getting the itch for March Madness, Arch Madness as well in St. Louis. We can't wait, and it's going to be a fun one because the games have been close as well as the standings in the Missouri Valley Conference.
Yeah, taking a look at those NBC standings right now. And it's a three-way race at the top. You know, of course, you got Loyola up there, Drake, Missouri State. But then there's Bradley right there in the middle at 12-11, but then Evansville down their bottom just won. Then they get the conference 5-15. All season they've been trying to figure out what their identity is and trying to find their groove here late in the season.
Yeah, trying to find their stride. It's a battle for first place at the top. Bradley, a dangerous team. I don't think their record is indicative of how good this team is, and they've been there before within the last 3 years at the top of the Valley.
Well, a big part why Bradley is so good is because Terry Roberts, the 6'3 junior from New York, averaging about 16 points per game this year, but he leads the Missouri Valley in assists per game. He's been a vital part to this Braves squad.
Such a versatile guard. He can dish it out to his teammates. He can score it as well, and he can play defense, get steals, as well as block shots. And what's so great about him, when you watch him play, it just seems like everything's so slow. He can just process everything on the floor.
And one of the few bright spots for Evansville offensively has been Juwan Newton. He scored 17 points in their last outing, a loss against Missouri State, but leads the team in rebounds at almost 6 per game.
And that's so fascinating because he's a bit undersized. He's a guard. He's listed at 6'3", but he doesn't give up on plays. He is going to go for the basketball. Even if you win it, he's going to take it away from you. That's Juwan Newton. He's going to find a way to score and make plays on the court for the Purple Aces.
The tail of the tape, obviously a lot of things favored towards Bradley. Braves almost averaging 72 points per game this season. And last time these two teams met was earlier this season on January 12th, a 79-47 blowout win for the Braves in Peoria, Illinois.
As you can see, a lot of those numbers favor the Braves going into this matchup. The rebounding battle stands out from the last game out. Bradley, a good offensive team, but they're also good defensively, just like the Purple Aces.
Bradley wins the tip, and we are rocking and rolling here from the Ford Center. We'll get to our starters here in just a minute, but the Braves have the basketball wearing their red road uniforms out the gate. Evansville on a man-to-man defense. Mass with the basketball, hands it off to Kent. They try to go pick and roll, and a good job by Evan Coleman. Knocks that one out of bounds. It will stay with Bradley. Now let's see those starters brought to you by Cytex, supplying uniforms, linens, mats, and more since 1961. Cytex, the image makers. Roberts, Hickman, Leons, Kent, and Mast, the starting five for the Braves. From Bradley, an offensive board there for Roberts. Mentioned his name in the pregame show as Hickman goes in and scores. Connor Hickman, the freshman from Bloomington, Indiana, makes it 2-0 Bradley, and there's your starting five for Evansville. Again, brought to you by Cytex, the image makers. Very similar group as what Evansville's enrolled with the past few games. That's one guy they got to get going. Evan Coleman, the fifth-year senior on this squad, was a big part of the team last season, but had a quiet fifth-year senior season. Here he is back and down with 6 on the shot clock. Dumps it off now to Phillips. There's Jamar Gibbons, a triple. It won't fall. And a good defensive start there for Bradley. 2-0 Braves. They go to the big man Mast down low, working against Coleman, and that's going to be something else to watch. The size advantage for Bradley against a relatively small Evansville team.
Rick Mask is a big man down inside, and that's the advantage for the Braves. He can muscle his way, and of course, he can win the battle of the glass pretty easily against most opponents. Evansville is going to have their hands full with the big man inside.
Last time out for Evansville was a loss at Missouri State. Final score of that one. It was a close one of that, or it was late at least. Evansville had a lead in the second half. Here's Newton. He'll try to fire one up, and it goes. Juwan Newton puts Evansville on the board. The keys to the game for this contest brought to you by Old National Bank, your bank for life.
So we've kind of already mentioned it. Get the ball inside, even though they shoot it from outside there, but Mast is the advantage for this Bradley's team against Evansville, but contest everything defensively. I'm not just talking about shots. I'm talking about getting in the passing lanes, good ball denial, fronting the post to make things tough for Evansville. For the Aces, they got to have a sense of urgency. They almost got to pretend sometimes like it's, you know, made that part of the second half against Missouri State where they made that big run to take the lead. And they got to win the position battles. They got to get to the spot on the movement, away from the basketball, and then as well get the inside position on a nice block out for the rebounding, because Evansville's a bit undersized. They got to get the position to win the rebounding battle.
It was a 14-point loss against the Bears of Missouri State, 72-58. There's a three-point shot in the corner. Jamar Gibbons for three. Three on the other, and before that was from Jason Kent for Bradley, and it's 7-5. Both teams swapping baskets offensively. Bradley 3-4. Evansville 2-3. There's a drive by Roberts, and he gets called for a travel. You can tell early on, besides that three-point shot in the last trip, Preston, they're wanting to get to the basket, rather it's with Roberts, mm-hmm. rather it's with Mass, go to the rim.
Yeah, it's so fascinating with this Bradley team. You know, when you look at their tempo offensively, they're one of the fastest teams in the Valley, as well as in the nation, but yet on the other end, they like to slow things down, really make the opposing team use the full shot clock.
Well, Shamar Gibbons throws that one out of bounds, but they're going to say it was tipped by a Brave, so it's going to stay with Evansville. Here in a 7-5 Bradley lead. Let's take a look. Close call. It's going to stay with Evansville, though. Aces 2-3 from the floor so far here in the first quarter. Preston Phillips will drive back to Gibbons. Puts on the floor, open. Frederick King for three, won't go.
And once again, it just seems like for Frederick King, that three-point shot's not quite been on the spot this year. It seems lower. It doesn't have quite the same trajectory we have seen in years past from Frederick King. And they, just like Kuhlman, he's the other senior that they need him to get going to give some help to Shamar Gibbons and Juwan Newton, the two double-figure scorers for the Aces.
Now you mentioned Frederick King and Kuhlman. Frederick King only 7.4 points per game this year and 6.4 from Kuhlman. Now you take in the other two players, Gibbons and Newton. If those four could really be on point all season long, this is an Evansville team that could easily have a flip-flop record right. than what they do right now.
And in that win a couple weeks ago against Illinois State, you know, after they had that big turnaround from the Friday night loss previously, Frederick King was in double figures. He had a solid game. That's why Evansville needs him to be more consistent. They need somebody else to be consistent as the third scorer.
Good steal defensively there by Evansville. A chance for the Aces to take their first lead of the contest, 7-5 Bradley. Newton on the drive out to Gibbons. We're at 16.5 to play here in the first half. Gibbons, isolation working against Roberts. The main game here with Phillips. The size advantage against Roberts. Now kicks it out to Kuhlman. He'll try a three. Won't go. You can tell early on, Bradley just everywhere defensively.
And they kind of have to because Evansville's playing with some good pace offensively. They're moving the basketball, moving their bodies. Something we're not used to seeing normally with this Evansville team. They like to take their time to find the best shot.
A nice move there by Roberts. Couldn't get his shot to go. As here comes Evansville the other way. Kuhlman, he'll try a three from the left corner. That time it also won't go. Man, a rough start for Evansville. From beyond the arc, just 1 of 5 into that miss there from Kuhlman. Still 7-5 Bradley. That's a three-point shot the other end that won't go either. And a foul going to be called on the rebound. Against whom is the question?
So it'll be on Kuhlman. Well, the referee saw 1-0.
That'll be immediate timeout. Bradley 7, Evansville 5. It's the Valley on ESPN.
I would consider us a collective of designers.
What's awesome is to be able to combine your fingers and the pen.
You have the snap tools and it's so responsive.
We've been working together from pretty much everywhere.
With Windows 11, we're just doing it better.
Treasure hunting, dirty business.
See Nathan Drake in Uncharted featuring the Adventure Ready Tucson.
It's a touchdown, football fans! Come into Arby's now and touch this brisket, bacon, and beef dip down into a cup of au jus. Arby's, we have the meat.
Thursday night.
Let me hear you, come on!
Find out who will bring home the game's most prestigious awards.
Makes it look easy!
Keep rising, keep changing the world.
NFL Honors, presented by Invisalign, Thursday at 9, 8 Central.
Last time these two teams met was earlier this season, back on January 12th, and it was all Bradley. A 79-47 win for the Braves in Peoria. And the Aces hoping the same thing doesn't happen this afternoon, but thanks to that guy right there, Reek Mass had a huge contest against these Purple Aces.
Yeah, big time. And he can't just leave him inside. He can step out and hit some jump shots as well, as most big men can nowadays. But they won the rebounding battle, which is always important to win games. And that's just a tough place to play up there in Carver Arena, especially for the Aces. And now Bradley has won the last eight in this series.
Yeah, Evansville has not defeated Bradley since 2018, the last time that Purple Aces came out victorious. And you see those numbers from that meeting earlier in the season. Aces were led by Newton and Gibbons, both with 16 points. But I mentioned Mass with 23 and Roberts with 19. Double double for both those guys. You get those two guys put numbers like that, you're going to win a lot of basketball games.
Yeah, double double for Mass. Flirting with kind of a triple double there for Roberts, but the defense held Evansville, as you saw that shooting percentage at the bottom of that graphic.
So Bradley ball after the media timeout, 7-5 Braves. Fans still making their way into the fourth center this afternoon, and another forced turnover there by the Aces, and defensively, Purple Aces not too bad to start the game.
Yeah, not too bad, getting their hands, making it difficult, not getting up easy looks.
See Blaze Beauchamp in the ball game for Evansville, as well as freshman Blake Sisley. 7-5 Bradley. Here's Coleman, top of the circle. Nice cut by Newton down low, but his shot set back by Boya. Harry Boya, the big man, 7'1", now a 3-point shot on the corner off the side of the backboard. But a big rejection there by Harry Boya, the 7'1" senior. Deflection out of bounds. It's going to stay with the Purple Aces. But again, the size for Bradley. You got 6'9" Mass down low, and then you swap him out and get a 7'1" player down low. Just too much right now for Evansville in the paint.
And Evansville trying to find that cutting action to the basket, but yet you got the rim protectors in the way, especially as you mentioned with Boya, the 7'1" senior.
Here's Givens. Still 7'5" Bradley, been that score for quite some time. Beauchamp on the drive, his floater. Good, we're tied at 7.
Known as a shooter, Beauchamp puts it on the deck and throws up the little teardrop.
Nearly 6.5 points per game this year for Blaze Beauchamp. We're tied at 7. Bradley trying to answer. 3-point shot, the top of the circle, that one won't fall. An offensive rebound by Boya leads to a man down low. It's gonna be Kent with the 2.
And just patience by Kent. He knew the defender was gonna come flying by. I'll just hold it a little extra longer, and then I'll get the wide open easy lay-in.
Bradley back in front. They've led or been tied the majority of the entirety of this ball game. Here's a freshman, Sisley. Gets it over to Gibbons. Gibbons trying to work around the big man. Back up to Sisley. Mid-range jumper for Blake Sisley won't fall. And the rebound in the hands of the Braves. Howe with the basketball and a 9-7. Brave lead, under 14 to go here in the first half. Man, the size advantage there with Boya, guarded by Gibbons. Now they switch it back off. They work it around. Now it's Kent who goes baseline. Offensive foul going to be called there against Jason Kent.
And it's Noah Frederickson sliding over, getting set from the help side defense to take that charge. We mentioned, you know, for Coleman and Frederickson, the seniors, you know, maybe the scoring touch hasn't quite been there this year, but that's something they always do every game. They're experienced enough now. They know where to get to the spot and set themselves.
Brian Wardle in his 12th year at the helm for Bradley. 2014 Horizon League Coach of the Year. He was a graduate of Marquette back in 01. In his 7th year here at the helm for the Bradley Braves. Still a 9-7 Bradley lead.
Built something pretty special up there in Peoria. 2 MVC tournament titles in 19 and 20 back-to-back. Had that streak ended last year, but they're always going to be contenders.
Frederick King, corner 3, gives Evansville their first lead of the afternoon, 9-10 Purple Aces. That's what you want to see from your senior.
Yeah, you want to see him knocking out those shots in the corner pocket, that's his spot.
Allen Mass tried to go pick and roll, it's not there. And the drive by Leon's off the glass won't fall. Here comes Evansville. Well, you're right. I want to get Frederick King, and how about this guy going? That's Coleman, who trying to go to Beauchamp in the corner. That's an Evansville turnover. Just their first of the day.
Kuhlman got stuck in no man's land. He really wasn't quite set with his feet to take a shot, even though he had the look. And he was kind of off balance. He tried to pass it and hopefully to get it back.
13th year for Todd Licklider. Just his third here in Evansville. And, of course, the record not where he wants it to be. But still, it feels like over the past couple of years, just kind of a work in progress, this Evansville team. Braves with the basketball and a 10-9 Evansville advantage. Howe puts on the floor. They don't go to the pick and roll. Roberts, three. Yes. Terry Roberts, his first basket of the afternoon. It's now a Bradley two-point advantage, 12-10.
The JUCO transfer has been so big for the Braves, and the fact of the matter is, as I mentioned earlier, I don't think their record is indicative of how good they are, and with a couple key JUCO transfers and some other mid-experience level players, Bradley can contend this year and next year.
Steal from Mikey Howell at the other end leads to Roberts, but they swing it around. Now it's Kent. He wants a three. Back-to-back triples for Bradley. It's a five-point Brave lead, 15-10, at the 12-minute mark here in the first half.
And we've seen Kent knock down a couple threes already in this game, and what I love about his stroke, he really releases the ball at the peak of his jump.
Evansville trying to answer. Mentioned back-to-back triples, a 6-0 Bradley run. 10 to shoot. Newton, double team. Now they go to the pick and rock. Pick and pop now to Givens. Givens, three to shoot. Givens to the basket. He'll draw the foul. That's going to be our first shooting foul of the contest. Be a couple of free throws here for Jamar Givens. Which will take us to our under 12 media timeout. How about Jason Kent? A couple of three-pointers. The Braves find themselves up by five. 11 and a half to play in this first half. 15-10 Braves at the Valley on ESPN.
There is a difference between an idea and an idea made real. At UE, we rise boldly to the challenge of making a difference and also dream big about solving the problems of today to better our world for tomorrow. We join together, knowing that side by side, we can truly make a difference. It's what makes us change makers. We step in, we stand out, and we reimagine everything. And it all starts here at the University of Evansville. Come change the world with us.
DoubleTree by Hilton Evansville is located in the heart of downtown Evansville within walking distance to many eating, shopping, and entertainment options. Our exemplary service starts with a warm chocolate chip cookie at check-in. Settle in to a beautiful king or queen guest room with HDTV, mini fridge, coffee maker, free Wi-Fi, and much more. Enjoy delicious meals at the Stone City Grill and local beers at the Quarry Bar. Our state-of-the-art business center is perfect for conferences and celebrations. DoubleTree by Hilton Evansville, a preferred partner of the Missouri Valley Conference.
Arch Madness.
It's all about
the excitement,
the fans,
the history,
the big moments.
Shoots at the horn. Good! Good!
It's all about
the madness.
To make it to the tournament.
And March,
it begins here.
I'll see you in St. Louis.
Visit archmadness.com for ticket information.
The Valley on ESPN is brought to you by Cytex, the image makers. Old National Bank, your bank for life. The DoubleTree by Hilton in downtown Evansville. State Farm, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And the Missouri Valley Conference, the Valley runs deep. Dave Snell, the voice of the Bradley Braves, his 43rd season behind the mic for Bradley. Truly incredible. Here downtown, here courtside downtown Evansville at the Ford Center for this one.
Yeah, and Dave Snell, one of the all-time greats in the Valley and top 10 nationally in terms of the longest tenured play-by-play voice. That also includes Mike Reese, the voice of the Salukis over in Southern Illinois. And for people in this area, they're familiar with Don Fisher, the voice of the Hoosiers. So, again, a pretty high list there. 43 seasons. Congrats to Dave Snell.
Well, Devin Redmond across the way, the Purple Aces radio guy. He's got a ways to go. Got some time to put in. Let's be on that list.
He's just a baby in this business.
A couple of free throws there for Shamar Gibbons. Back to a three-point Bradley lead, 15-12 after the 12-minute media timeout. Nice move by Mikey Howell to the rim for two. That time it's defensive lapse there for Evansville, and They've had their moments defensively in this first half. Bradley, 50% from the field, 7 of 14. Aces just 4 of 10. Foul's going to be called there on Jason Kent. Both teams playing clean basketball so far. Only two fouls called against the Purple Aces and four against Bradley here early on. Like I said, it's been the shooting that's been hurting Evansville so far in this one.
It's been kind of a problem throughout the year for the Aces offensively. The jump shooting and the field goal percentage. Even though Givens and Newton find ways to score, they have faced some tough defenders in the Valley. They've seen their efficiency go down a little bit in Valley play.
Roberts causing the steal there with a tip pass. Now it's Roberts. Step back three. What a move, but his shot couldn't go with an offensive rebound. And they're going to call.
I believe they're flopping on Roberts.
Yeah, I think you're right. Roberts tried the step back jumper. And that's going to be against Terry Roberts. Kind of hard to tell from our view, but it will still be Bradley ball. 5-point Braves lead. Roberts will inbound. Down the right corner. Nice drive and a floater. That one won't fall. And loose basketball. Who's got it? Givens on the floor. Going to be a jump ball with the arrow in favor of Evansville.
And Evansville needed that stoppage because Frederick had to peel away from the play. He looks like he has a lower leg injury. Might have came down awkwardly and he's going to get some attention and a substitution as well.
Didn't see it during the play, but you're right, Preston. Frederick King being helped over to the Aces bench. And, you know, despite the scoring struggles, you never want to have a senior go down, especially this point in the season. You need him out there on the floor. So Evansville ball and a 5-point Bradley lead. Beauchamp with it. That's going to be a foul against Roberts. The second foul of that against Roberts, so I got to wonder if he's got to take a seat for quite some time. But back to that previous play, and right there, got twisted up.
Looks like he actually caught Newton's boot a little bit.
Well, those never feel good, that's for sure. Givens out to Coleman, back to Givens. Nice move to the basket. Now it's Phillips down low who gets stuck. 8 to shoot and a steal here by Bradley once again. Howe picks it off and a foul in transition going to be called against Evansville.
And Fred Keane's over there walking around and looks like he's moving pretty decently, so nothing too severe. So I would think he would be good to get back into this game. Looks like he caught himself before that foot completely gave out because Evansville definitely needs his experience on the floor.
Again, Frederick King, 7.4 points per game this season, a fifth-year senior. Hopefully he's not gone for too long. Nice pick and roll with Boya, the two-handed flush on the alley-oop. Extends this Bradley lead back up to 7, 19 to 12. Here's Givens. Working against Hickman. Now it's Coleman in the far corner. Coleman working against Lyons, and his floater won't fall. Another defensive stop there for Bradley. Braves trying to make a run here midway through the first half. Left side here, Stavanian. Boya hands it off to Hickman. Pick and roll of Boya again. How do you stop that? Boya's shot wouldn't go, but a foul's going to be called on the rebound. They will call a foul on the shot, so it will be free throws for the big man, Ari Boya.
Foul on Coleman, that's his second personal. Ooh.
We got Frederick King, who's, of course, trying to work through an injury. Now you got Coleman with two fouls, so your two seniors. It sits for a few minutes here for time to look at our squad. Blake Sisley back into the ball game. Second free throw here for Boya. It was 1 of 2. Beauchamp the rebound for Evansville, down by 8. Evansville has not scored in about 2.5 minutes. Bit of a 5-0 run here for Bradley. And an 11-2 run in the past 4 minutes. Here's Givens. Now it's Phillips. Thought about a three. Puts it on the deck. Back to Givens. Floater from Gibbons won't fall. And again, a big defensive stop there for Bradley, extending this lead here. And now there's an injured Brave player. That's going to be Mikey Howell, who's limping towards his own bench.
And that's the graduate transfer for Bradley. That's the thing. Bradley kind of had to reload from what was already in the college ranks, you know, different levels this year, and they found some quality talent across the board.
Well, a good sign here for Evansville. Noah Frederick King checks back in the game. He seems all right. Still an 8-point Bradley advantage, 20-12, under 9 to play here in the first half. Again, trying to go to that pick and roll of Boya. That time Hickman pulls up the freshman, can't get his shot to go, and Boya's going to commit the foul as him and Newton fought for the rebound, but Newton won that battle.
Yeah, Newton went up, got it, and Boya tried to slap it out while he was airborne.
We saw Newton flying for that rebound. Big part why he leads the team in that category, almost 6 boards per game for Juwan Newton. Evansville trying to end this scoreless streak of almost 3 minutes now without a basket. Gibbons over to Frederick King, back to Gibbons. Beauchamp, deep three. It won't fall.
And for Evansville, I mean, they're moving with a pretty good tempo on offense. They're moving the basketball. You know, sometimes they get caught being stagnant on the offensive half-court side at times, but the shots are just not going in.
Tama Nyan for three on the left wing over Beauchamp to make it now an 11-point Bradley lead. What a run here for the Braves halfway through this first half. A 14-2 run here for the Braves. Here's Sisley. Now Frederick King thought about a three. Newton on the floor. He'll pull up for a mid-range jumper, and again, another Evansville miss. That has been the story of this first half for the Purple Aces. Tavanian, Euro step to the basket. His shot won't fall. With an offensive rebound and a second chance here for the Braves. And that's going to be a travel. That's going to be our under-8 media timeout. Things are looking down for Evansville. It's a 14-2 Bradley run, thanks to the play from Harry Boya. Off the bench, take immediate timeout to the Valley on ESPN.
7-1 Sarah Boya with the jam.
America's been thunderstruck by the all-new 2022 Mitsubishi Outlander. With a sleek exterior and premium interior, get high style without the high price during the spring sales event. Get thunderstruck.
Are you kidding me? I'm getting sick of the industry. Oh, please.
These stuffs wanna kill me, but I won't let it. And I try to give them hell, but they don't get it. So I tell myself when I sleep at night, don't lose sight, baby, don't lose sight. This life will get you down, but I keep living. So I tell myself when I sleep at night, don't lose sight, baby, don't lose sight.
Custom Inc. helps us celebrate and drive our students' achievements with custom gear. They love Custom Inc.'s different styles and designs. We love how Custom Inc. makes the process simple with their easy-to-use design lab, expert artists ready to help, and unbeatable customer service. Custom Inc. allows our kids to show everyone their accomplishments and the pride they have in our school. When we place an order, I know they got our back, so we can focus on the kids.
Custom Inc. has hundreds of products to help you feel connected. Upload your logo or start your design today at CustomInc.com.
USAA is made for the safe pilots, like Sergeant Hayden, who won't return a call until the engine's cool. With USAA Safe Pilot, when you drive safe, you can save up to 30% on your auto insurance. USAA, what you're made of, we're made for. Get a quote today.
It's Saturday prime time.
Knicks Lakers on ABC.
here at the Ford Center, downtown Evansville. It's been all Bradley in this one so far. Braves currently on a 14-2 run in the past 5 minutes and 50 seconds, but close calls has been the story of the season for Evansville. They've only won one of these 5 games decided by 5 points or less. That was that win against Illinois State, as you mentioned earlier, Preston, but you know, like we said earlier, it's an Evansville team that easily could have a flip-flop record if just some things go in their way.
And the thing that I noticed about all those games, except for the Rice game, all at home. Evansville, for some reason, the road games have been really a nuisance to the Aces this year. Again, that Rice game was a neutral site tournament during the Thanksgiving week. All those other games at home, so they're getting the home court advantage, at least of getting it close, but Evansville's game right now is starting to be in trouble here with the offense just not seeing shots go through the bottom of the net, and Bradley's taking advantage.
23-12, Bradley advantage. We're under 8 to play in this first half. It's been a quiet past 5 or so minutes for the Purple Aces. They did lead 9-10 or 10-9 at one point in this first half. Give it stuck in the corner. By the freshman Hickman has swing it around. 4 to shoot here for Beauchamp and the Aces. He'll fire. He'll miss. And again, that Bradley defense forcing tough shots. The shot clock's winding down.
And not only that, but not allowing Newton or Shamar Givens to be the ones taking those shots. They're forcing the other guys to get the basketball and put the shot up. With Beauchamp, normally you feel pretty confident because he has such a good stroke, a good shooter, but he's having a rough time from the field so far as well.
This Bradley team shooting just 9 of 20 from the field in this first half, but it's good enough for an 11-point lead. There's Mass, who's been quiet in this game. Morgan, it's the freshman Sisley, and that was a little bit too easy right there. Mass has 4 points.
And that's a matchup to look forward to seasons to come. Mass, only a sophomore. The two, Mass and Sisley, kind of have similar body builds.
Here's Newton, nearly lost his dribble. In Evansville, cold spell continues in this first half. Nice drive by Givens out to Beauchamp for 3, and the cold spell continues.
And again, just not even allowing the Aces to get inside. They're forcing Evansville to kick it out.
Tavanian, his 3 won't fall, but he gets his own offensive rebound. Another second chance here for the Braves. Great ball movement, and it's leading to a Hickman layup. The freshman, Connor Hickman. And all of a sudden, Bradley has opened the floodgates, a 15-point advantage.
And I'll bring up one other play that I haven't seen a whole lot of from Evansville this year that we've seen last year and the year before that when they had some winning records in the Valley and, you know, some winning some games. We normally saw that back cut play where Noah Fredekin would get lost along the baseline and get the easy layup. We haven't seen much of that this year, and that's something that I'm kind of curious on why that's kind of gone out of the mix a little bit, because Evansville got some easy points on that play where, again, Fredekin was on the baseline, the backup play, kind of getting lost behind the defense.
So Blake Sisley will shoot a pair of free throws here after the foul being called against Mast. Just the first foul on Mast. And Phillips also will check back in for Evansville. You know, Evan Coleman, he committed a couple of early fouls. He'll probably be on the bench the rest of the first half, I would guess. Sisley goes 1 of 1.
And with him being in foul trouble, Evansville's depth is kind of being tested because they're kind of limited in terms of their true, you know, 5-spot players.
Lead down to 14 here for Bradley. Here's Hickman. 10 to shoot here for the Braves. Pick and roll, Boya, not there now. It's Hickman, back to Boya. Somehow got that pass in there. That's going out of bounds, U of E ball.
As Evansville traditionally just goes between Kuhlman and Sisley playing the 5 spot. Haven't seen a whole lot of minutes from Inaruna throughout the season.
We knew coming into this game that Bradley was going to have the advantage down low in terms of not only size, but strength also. You see the two guys that are both in the game right now, Boya and Mast. Both have made their impacts early on. Here's Givens, back to Sisley. He'll try a 3, it's short.
He got a tough contest on the shot from the 7-1 Boya.
They go with the pick and roll back to Boya. That layup up and good. 7'1", Harry Boya. That's tough to defend. Todd Ladder wants a timeout. And it's a 16-point Bradley lead. 30-second break, so we'll stay here. Ooh, if you're Evansville, not much going your direction at all in this contest.
Yeah, not much, because they're having a tough time getting inside. And at this point, with all the shots hitting the rim, Bradley's okay with saying, hey, we'll step back, we'll clog up the lane, let you all take those shots until you can prove that you can make those outside jump shots. But it's so fascinating for Bradley. They lost a great forward last year to graduation, Elijah Childs, but yet they bring the likes of Mast and Boya into the fold, and it's like they haven't even missed a beat with their inside presence.
When you see how they fare in the rebounding side of things, they're in the top of the NBC and the top 100 of the nation of almost every category in the rebounding game. And you know, when you have two big guys down like that, 7'1" and 6'9", you're going to be pretty good off in the rebound department.
Yeah, today it's 21 rebounds for Bradley, only 6 for Evansville, because obviously numbers a little skewed with all the missed shots by Evansville. The rebounding opportunity is there for Bradley, and they're making their shots, which limits the rebounding chances defensively for Evansville.
Good move by Sisson, but his shot won't go. Aces 4 of 18 from the field in this first half. See that 20-3 run right now in the past 9 minutes for Bradley, make it 22-3. Howell with another lay-in.
And getting the step on Newton, and now going the other way. Newton got lost in the shuffle.
Well, that's the first field goal in almost 9 minutes there for Evansville. Again, the cold spell in this second part of the first half. 31-15, a 16-point Bradley advantage. There's the pick and roll. Boya going for the alley-oop slam, and a foul's going to be called. And now we will have a media timeout break. 31-15 Bradley. Valley on ESPN.
That was then.
And this is now.
McMahon Exterminating has stood the test of time. Now 3 generations of pest management professionals serving you for the last 50 years. Thank you for allowing us to serve your family and businesses.
And thank you for trusting us with all your pest control needs for the past 50 years.
Remember, who can help with all your pest control needs for the next 50 years?
McMahon can.
Welcome to the College Tour and the episode featuring the University of Evansville. Explore and learn about the UE through real students and alumni about their personal experiences on campus and beyond. You will visit our Evansville campus and UE Study Abroad Center, Harlickson College, in Grantham, England. In this episode, you will learn more about campus life, academics, undergraduate research, sports, clubs, activities, and more. You can watch this episode online at evansville.edu/thecollegetour.
People assume these photo shoots are easy.
Just like they assume they can't afford great insurance. But State Farm has rates that fit any budget.
Gorgeous. What?
Can I get a profile?
All in the core.
For surprisingly great rates that fit any budget, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
NBC student athletes are positively impacting the communities where they live by sharing views and fostering a climate for change for future Valley pioneers. Learn more about mobilizing voices for change. Visit nbc-sports.com/onevalley. Been a pretty good spell for Bradley over the last 5 games. A tough loss on the road to UNI earlier this week, but they had won 5 or 4 straight games before that, including a couple impressive wins, including that big win against Drake on the 19th of January. That's really sticks out the most.
And not only that, but on the road in Des Moines against the Bulldogs, winners of 5 of their last 7. So again, it feels like Bradley might be hitting a good stride here at the turning halfway point, if you will, of the Valley season.
Well, a good stride in the first 10 or so minutes, or 16 or so minutes so far this afternoon. 32-15 advantage as Boya able to go 1 of 2 from the free throw line, but there's Mast for the offensive rebound, and it'll be a jump ball as the shot was blocked by Frederick. And again, the offensive rebounds are Preston so far this afternoon. Bradley 8, Evansville none.
Yeah, the second chance is because the height advantage, and that's where I mentioned, you know, for Evansville, they're going to have the disadvantage of the height. That's why they have to get the inside rebounding position.
There's Kent, mid-range jumper. He's been lights out so far. Kent with 10 points. A 19-point Bradley lead, 34-15.
And Inaruna is now in the game for Evansville, so we'll see how he can do against Mass and possibly Boya when he checks back in. But for Preston Phillips, the freshman, the rebounding game has been his strong suit, but he's not been able to get the chances here tonight. Normally he can do the dirty work for the Aces and go clean the glass.
Nearly an Aces turnover there. That pass was deflected by Roberts as Givens with miscommunication there with Frederick King, but three on the shot clock here for the Purple Aces.
But as you see there, despite the score, the turnovers, both teams doing a pretty good job of taking care of the basketball, no surprise. As it was kind of interesting going into this game and doing our preparation, you know, kind of early in the season, both teams, as the shot clock winds down, both teams were having trouble, especially in their losses, of averaging about 14 or more turnovers per game. Yet they've been playing better here in Valley play. They've dropped that number by four down to like 10 turnovers per game. So both teams have improved in terms of ball security.
That shot clock violation, the fifth Evansville turnover. Only six for Bradley. 3 minutes to go in this first half, 34-15 Braves. There's Mass down low, his shot won't fall. Phillips the rebound for Evansville.
And as we have seen, maybe the category of the points off turnovers has been big in Valley play, especially as close as some of the games have been.
Inaruna working against Mass, nice drive by Inaruna. It'll be a couple of free throws for Ian Inaruna. Well, if you're Evansville and you're looking for someone to, I guess, hold your ground down low and battle amongst the trees like Bradley has done, and you put Inaruna in the ball game and he goes to the free throw line.
And that's the thing about Inaruna, when you kind of get that fire going inside of him, get him burning a little bit, he's going to muscle his way around down on the block, go to work, and kind of assert himself into the game.
His first free throw short, Boya back in the ball game. As Mast will take a much deserved rest. Inaruna goes one of two. Back down an 18-point game, 34-16. If you're Evansville, he's final 2 minutes and 40 seconds. A great time to get something going, positive way, in terms of the second half.
Yeah, it's always important to get a little momentum going into the locker room where you'll make the adjustments, talk things over.
Left side, Hickman left wide open for a triple. It won't go. Newton flies in for the rebound. So again, final, big final 2.5 minutes in this first half for Evansville, trailing by 18. Newton against Hickman. His pull-up jumper won't fall, way off the mark that time. Boya with the rebound. At the other end, Hickman. How about that side? Also no good. Frederick the rebound. Either team doing great from beyond the arc. Bradley 4 of 11. Meanwhile, Evansville just 2 of 9 as Lyons flies in there to block that shot. So Lyons getting up and sending that one out of bounds. And again, Evansville, nothing has come easy in this first half. Is that an inbounds pass? Is deflected out of bounds once again. 5 of 21 from the field this first half for Evansville. Just under 24%. Inaruna has the inbounds pass, and Aces will snap their offense. Yeah, stand at the bottom of your screen. One of the last 11 shots made for Evansville. Frederick King, nice move, but his shot won't go again. And they've had good looks, Preston. Just can't get him to fall.
Yeah, a lot of good looks here today for Evansville. But again, being kind of forced to take jump shots, they're not getting anything easy inside.
Great backdoor cut from Hickman, the pass from Boya, but Hickman couldn't get it to go. So a couple of stops for Evansville defensively, and they can't answer offensively. Here's Givens. Gonna set this one up. Givens, step back three. The cold spell yet again continues for the Purple Aces. After Bradley, a chance to go 2-for-1 here to end the first half. Under a minute to go, the first 20 minutes. Howe going left side against Newton. All the way to the rack, and Newton able to send it back, and Phillips saves it right into the hands of Lyons. Hickman, three, yes! Connor Hickman with the triple. And the lead is now 21 for the Braves at 37-16. Newton. an 8-second difference in the shot and game clock. Gibbons goes left side, double team, back out. Phillips thought about a three. Now we'll try a three. It's good. Just the third main triple for Evansville in this first half. And Brian Wardle wants a timeout.
Yeah, use it or lose a timeout for Bradley to set up a play, try to get, you know, at least one last basket, one last look with 12 seconds left here in the first half. That was big for Evansville, you know, just to see something go through the bottom of the net for the confidence. But look at that recovery by Newton. He got beat by Howell once again on that first step, but he recovers back to get the swat. But Hickman is having a big day. I mean, he has been kind of forgotten around the arc at times, and he's hitting the shots.
Well, the confidence for Hickman as well. He's 3-7 from the field, but you can tell whenever he gets the ball, it's no hesitation. It's going up, and for a freshman, it's pretty impressive. 6'3" freshman from Bloomington, Indiana.
Yeah, he's going to be big time. I mean, yeah, averaging 6 points per game, but that's second in the Valley among freshmen. So it looks like he has such a high ceiling going forward, perhaps, for these Braves. And that's what you like to see. You see the potential there because you got a solid group of upperclassmen, but you know that you can go to the young guys on the bench this season and know that those guys are going to take the baton, if you will, going forward in the future seasons.
So 12 seconds for Bradley to go length of the floor. In the hand of Roberts, now 8 seconds. Roberts with six. Back to Roberts, three for Roberts with the left hand, pull-up jumper off the mark, and Evansville gets a defensive stop to end the first half. But still all Bradley there in the first 20 minutes, 37-19. We go to halftime here at the Ford Center.
Put the sandwich in the dip. Brisket, bacon, beef, and Swiss. You put the sandwich in the dip. Brisket, bacon, beef, and Swiss. You put the sandwich in the dip. Brisket, bacon, beef, and Swiss. You put Arby's. We have the meat.
I am Kyle Nakasugi, founder of ClearCover. I am reinventing how insurance is delivered using cutting-edge technology. And my path started at the Wisconsin School of Business at UW-Madison.
America's been thunderstruck by the all-new 2022 Mitsubishi Outlander.
With a sleek exterior and premium interior, get high style without the high price during the spring sales event. Get thunderstruck.
I would consider us a collective of designers.
What's awesome is to be able to combine your fingers and the pen.
You have the snap tools and it's so responsive.
We've been working together from pretty much everywhere.
With Windows 11, we're just doing it better.
Come check it out.
It may not be music to your ears, but as long as it's music to theirs, bring the volume back to the venue with exclusive ticket access to unmissable events. One of the many reasons you're with Amex Platinum.
So I'm going to, right?
If that particular play doesn't happen, I don't know what happens with my career beyond that.
A conference? Nah. Juggernaut. First rivalries, first traditions, first dynasties.
Old rivals, North Carolina versus State.
The first look and how it all went down.
What a finish for the season!
The Tournament premieres Monday at 9 on ACC Network.
I'm here at the Ford Center. It's all Bradley there in the first half, 37-19. A halftime score, and in the inside game, the outside game, rebounding, and Evansville not able to hit shots there in the first 20 minutes, Preston.
Just a tough go about it offensively for the Aces. They were able to get one last three from Phillips there, but Talking about Bradley, though, they've come to play here today. They've gotten inside, getting the points in the paint. They're hitting their outside shots with 5 threes in the first half. That's pretty good balance, and they're spreading out the scoring among their lineup as well.
You kind of pick your poison for the most impressive thing from Bradley. They're in the first half talking about Moya and Mass, the two guys down low, but the shooting as well. Mm-hmm. Guys like Jason Kent and, of course, Taylor Roberts, we know him, but they were very impressive there in that first half.
Yeah, the thing is, we didn't mention Roberts, but for one make from three, it's been Hickman, it's been Jason Kent. And that just shows, again, just the lineup that Bradley presents and the challenges because, okay, normally you can maybe focus on one or two key guys, you know, makes the other guys shoot and beat you. Well, those other guys are still beating the Aces because they have so much scoring depth on their roster.
Stat-wise, they're in the first half, and you can't help but notice 25% from the field, just 6 of 24 for Evansville compared to 45.5% for Bradley from the field, 3 of 11 from the on the arc for the Purple Aces and 5 of 12 from downtown. Mentioned the rebounding department, 27-12.
In one half? Are you kidding me?
You couldn't really ask for a better first half for Bradley there in the first 20 minutes.
Yeah, some teams are lucky to get 27 in a game. But for Bradley, it's all going well here in the Ford Center.
Arch Madness coming up, as we mentioned before the game, later on, or the start of next month, that is. Arch Madness is back. The 2022 State Farm MVCs Men's Basketball Tournament returns to St. Louis for the 32nd straight year. Join your team in the Gateway City March 3rd through 6th as all 10 Valley schools battle it out for a trip to the NCAA tournament. Also, in making plans to attend Arch Madness, please be aware of the current Enterprise Center policy, which requires all fans to provide proof of vaccination status or negative COVID test within 72 hours of your game. And fans are also required to wear a mask except when you're eating or drinking. For more information regarding health and safety measures for Arch Madness, go to archmadness.com. And again, just a month away from Arch Madness, the MVC tournament in St. Louis. We'll be right back. It's the Valley on ESPN.
Service has always been a big part of my life. I never shy away from challenges. It's a mindset that's been shaped by playing sports and serving in the Marines. I'm driven to have an impact far beyond myself. It's what pushed me to redefine disaster relief. Today, I'm creating a bold model for charitable giving. I'm here to make a difference, to be trusted to lead when there is no blueprint.
I'm Jake Wood, founder and CEO of Groundswell. I launched a company to reinvent philanthropy.
And my path started at the Wisconsin School of Business at UW-Madison.
Bringing home the Batman calzone from Little Caesars might make you feel like Batman. But could you really be the Batman?
A little help here!
Never mind. But at least the new Batman calzone with a calzone crust will make you feel like you're a superhero. The Batman, in theaters March 4th.
Pizza, pizza.
GMC Sierra, with hands-free driving, offers the most advanced and luxurious pickup in its class. Yeah, it rocks.
When you shop at Target, you leave with what you value most, like healthy foods and brands that lift our communities. At Target, the things that matter are always within reach. What we value most shouldn't cost more.
The people you love. Mark this moment in time and celebrate every kiss. Get zero down special financing with the K Jewelers credit card.
Dinner. It's more than just a meal you make every night. It's a chance to slow down and catch your breath. We'll show you how easy it is by focusing on your five senses. What do you see? Do you hear anything? What do you smell? How's it taste? Here's to a better, more mindful dinner routine.
Go to HelloFresh.com and use code RESH16 for 16 free meals plus 3 free gifts.
if that particular play doesn't happen. I don't know what happens with my career beyond that.
Everyone, let's hear from Arthur. He's a sophomore who is majoring in sports communications. He's going to share how, starting as a freshman, he was able to already be on ESPN as a commentator for a Division I university. Let's go, Aces. Take it away, Arthur.
Hey, everyone. I'm so excited to talk to you about the sports programs at the University of Evansville. The Purple Aces play at the Division I level and are members of the Missouri Valley Conference. The MVC, or the Valley, as we like to say, is one of the top mid-major conferences in the country. Growing up, it was my dream to be on ESPN. I came to UE for the sports communication major, but I also got an opportunity to be a part of the Fellow Scholars Program, which allows underrepresented students like myself to attend tuition-free. At UE, students and staff broadcast Aces home sporting events on the Valley on ESPN, which is prominently featured on ESPN Plus and ESPN 3. This gives students the opportunity to direct, produce, and announce games. As a freshman, I jumped in and was able to be a part of the Purple Aces production crew. This gave me a chance to see what goes on behind the scenes and on camera. Evansville currently competes in 17 varsity sports at the Division I level. Being located in Indiana, we are most known for our basketball programs. Our men have won 5 national championships, while our women have competed in multiple Division I NCAA tournaments. While basketball is a huge deal on campus, each of our other sports have endured a great level of success. In the last year, we have won conference championships in women's golf and track and field, while our other sports have built a strong foundation for an amazing future. I believe what surprised me the most was that I was able to come in my freshman year, be on screen, and commentating. The program is truly top-notch, and I am very excited for the future. Back to you, Alex.
Thanks, Arthur, for sharing your story. It is amazing the opportunities that UE is able to offer their students. That was fantastic. Take care.
I'm Sanai Atsbiha, VP of Brand Marketing at Gymshark. I help brands shape the future. And my path started at the Wisconsin School of Business at UW-Madison.
If you're always asking, where next? Capital One has a new class of travel card for you. Introducing Venture X. Earn 10x miles on hotels and 5x miles on flights booked through Capital One Travel. Plus, receive premium travel benefits like access to over 1,300 airport lounges. Find your where next with Venture X. What's in your wallet?
Why is it when someone says, I'm toast, it's not a good thing?
I'd be happy if I was toast.
Why?
Because I'd be delicious. Sonic Patty Melt. And everyone would love me.
Vivid Seats, your ticket to soul-raising, heart-racing, 100 beats per minute, what are we wearing? Once-in-a-lifetime memories in the making, bumps like a goose brisket for tailgating, reach for the universe, rapid breathing, can't catch my breath, top of lungs singing. This is it. The moment is now. Can you believe it? Wow. Get your tickets at Vivid Seats. Life happens live.
3 days in a row, huh?
I know, right?
Let's do this.
It's like an album drop at home.
Peloton, let's get hyped for the weekend. Shoulders on fire.
It's a secret to my superhuman muscle strength.
It's my focus, my center, my lunch break. Take my breath. Woo!
The A-game automates the mundane and keeps the competition guessing.
When your business is on its A game, the only competition it has is itself.
Become an autonomous digital enterprise with BMC.
Just take it slow. Slow, slow.
Mom?
Wow.
Wow.
And we'll check them both for free.
Yes.
Fix Finder, the most complete free warning light report backed by technician verified fixes.
Championship is at stake. Israel Adesanya!
I'm still the best in the world.
Robert Whittaker!
Be careful what you ask for.
Untangled.
NBC student athletes are positively impacting the communities where they live by sharing views and fostering a climate for change for future Valley pioneers. To learn more about mobilizing voices for change, visit nbc-sports.com/onevalley. The 19 leaders over Evansville. As we take a look at the Valley news and notes right now in the Missouri Valley Conference. And finalists for the Julius Irving Award. Lucas Williamson from Loyola has a much-watched game on Sunday. Tomorrow, as Missouri State will take on Loyola, that's on ESPN2. Valley ranks 11th in NCAA net rankings. But a big contest tomorrow between Missouri State and Loyola, again on ESPN2. So a couple of shifts here and there with a couple of teams joining the NBC starting next year. Murray State will join the club, as well as Belmont and University of Illinois Chicago up there in Chicago, the newest member to join the NBC. And Larry Birdwatch, Isaiah Mosley from Missouri State, Antonio Reeves from Illinois State, and A.J. Green of Northern Iowa, all the top three in the Larry Bird Watch here in 2022. Three of the most entertaining players in the nation here in the Missouri Valley Conference. Well, for entertaining purposes for Evansville, a lot to change in that first half. Not a very good first 20 minutes for the Purple Aces.
Yeah, it was so fascinating about that first half is Evansville. They looked like they were competing with Bradley those first, you know, handful of 8 minutes or so. You know, it was 10-9 at one point, and then they just went cold offensively. Bradley kind of stepped up, I think, the intensity just a little bit on defense to give them some credit as well, and they took off with it.
This season, when leading at halftime, Bradley 11-3 here in 2021-2022, so hoping to make that 12-3 this afternoon. In 37-19 as we start the second half of action. Starting five out there for Evansville. Here's Givens working against a Phillips screen. Now Kuhlman, he'll fire a right corner three, and the rough afternoon continues for Evan Kuhlman. He's 0 for 4.
I was kind of surprised for Evansville. Givens had the ball up top guarded by Mast. So advantage in terms of speed in that first step for Givens as Leons makes the basket. Instead of bringing up the screen, just space it out. Let Givens go to work, because that's when he's at his best. When, you know, he gets that mismatch, especially in terms of speed, he can go around the big man. You just got to isolate it, let it be wide open.
One of the best isolation players in the conference, Givens, as Preston mentioned there. 10 to shoot here for the Purple Aces. The basket by Lamb to the other end, back to a 20-point Bradley lead, 39-19. Givens out to Kuhlman. He's 0 for 4. Make it 1 of 5. And then Kuhlman gets in the scoring column. Leon's trying to answer at the other end, but now here's Bradley. But Preston, it's little things like that. 3-point shots from your senior. Evansville's got to hit those good looks if they want to have a chance to come back and win this game.
And getting the make, they were able to set up defensively with a 2-2-1 press a little bit.
A shot by Mast. Givens the board. Here he comes the other way. 39-22, Bradley. Kuhlman on the far side and nearly turned that one over, and he did, over and back. It's the sixth Evansville turnover.
And of course, it's well noted how deep into the shot clock Evansville works sometimes in the half court, and some people wonder, well, how does that happen? Well, sometimes Evansville, because they get stagnant, they create themselves into a logjam situation, creating their own traffic where there's no space to work with. And that's this is a team in Evansville that has to space it out for it to be successful in the half court.
Big man Mass from beyond the arc can't get that one to go. Evansville on the run again as Newton will draw the foul on his way to the basket. Defensively, you can't really knock Evansville too much. I mean, Bradley's just made the shots when they've had them, but defensively, Evansville has had their moments where they've looked pretty good.
Yeah, Evansville's, you know, gotten to the deflections, gotten some turnovers, and they've forced Bradley to the outside shot, taking away the inside at times. But again, credit to Bradley, they've stepped up and hit those outside shots from behind the arc.
Givens nearly turned it over, and they're going to call, I believe they're going to say that Kent was out of bounds, as Givens did a great job of saving that one from either being taken away or getting called for a travel. And yep, Kent was out of bounds, so it's going to stay with Evansville. 17-point Bradley advantage, 39-22. They're figuring out how much time to put on the shot clock, currently sitting at zero. So we'll be a reset new shot clock here for Evansville. At least the moment. Evansville, as you mentioned earlier, Preston, they're only leading the contest that 10-9 lead. They came with a 13-minute mark there in the first half, and it was pretty much downhill from there. Gave Bradley a big halftime advantage. Ended up putting about 15 on the shot clock here for Evansville. Here's Givens. Working against Lyons. Nice move by Givens. Out to Coleman. Fredericking left wing three. No good. Again, good ball movement and a good look for Evansville, but no avail. And a steal at the other end as Givens has it now against Roberts. And a great defensive play by Terry Roberts to knock that one away. It was 1-on-3. Roberts, the lone defender, and he saves an easy Evansville bucket.
The other thing for Evansville, especially with the way they try to kind of work in and kick it back out, taking a lot of threes, they're not getting a lot of contact opportunities to draw fouls going to the basket inside. Therefore, they're not getting to the line a whole lot, you know, able to put points up with the clock stopped, those kind of scenarios.
Another foul that time called against Jason Kent. That's his third foul, so Kent, who's been a big piece of the Bradley offense, will have to take a seat for quite some time with his third personal. Again, still 17-point Bradley advance, 39-22. But a relatively quiet day for Jawan Newton. Does have 4 points. Nice backdoor cut to Fredericking. His layup won't go. There's that backdoor cut you mentioned earlier in the broadcast, Preston. It was there, but much like Evansville's shots, good looks, couldn't get him to go. Backdoor cut that time with Lyons and one. And a chance for an old-fashioned three-point play as he flies into our baseline cameraman. And again, just got right behind Coleman. It was a great design, great look there from Lyons, and a great pass from Mast. And it's just little lapses like that that Evansville has really hurt themselves with today.
Yeah, that was a great view of it. You kind of saw Coleman kind of get himself a little bit. I mean, it doesn't take much. It's a few inches out of position where it's tough to keep vision on both ball and the man. Lyons was able to get behind him.
5 points for Malavi Lyons. Back to a 20-point Bradley lead, 42-22. Nice cut there by Gibbon until he went out of bounds. 10 to shoot here for the Aces. Fredericking got in the lane. His layup won't go. And the rebound into the hands of Tavanian for Bradley. Roberts left wide open. Can't do that. Terry Roberts, triple.
Just so unselfish, this basketball team for Bradley. The way they're moving the basketball. Getting everybody involved. And they're getting themselves in good positions on the floor to make good plays.
Largest lead of the afternoon for the Braves at 23, 45-22. Couple of subs for both teams. See Boya check back in for Bradley, and Blake Sicily also in for Evansville.
And on that last offensive possession for the Brazier, Leon's got that basket on the back cut down the lane.
Beauchamp corner three won't go, but he got his own rebound. Second chance here for Evansville.
They got the ball to a valuable spot on the floor along that baseline. Not quite in the corner where it's a coffin corner scenario, but along the baseline. That opens up the floor to make multiple plays for guys away from the basketball.
Here's Sisley. Working against Howell. Sisley left it short, but he got his own board. And his second attempt won't go either. Aces fans pleading for a foul, but no call. Mikey Howell directing traffic. Saw him go down there in the first half with the injury, but he's back in there for Bradley. Roberts out to Howell. Left-handed three. Good for Mikey Howell. 26-point Bradley advantage.
And once again, Bradley just takes advantage of the collapsing D by Evansville, especially from the help side and the weak side of the basketball.
Here's Givens. Got it stripped, nearly taken away into the hands now of Frederick. He'll go baseline out to Beauchamp. See Evansville locking to drive and kick, and a nice move by Beauchamp. Got Boya to go in the air, and he hits the jumper. See a bit of a half-court pressure applied now by Evansville, back down to a 24-point lead. Three-point shot for Lyons won't go, but there's Boya grabbing the offensive rebound and putting it back up and in. How do you defend 7'2" flying in the paint like that? 50-24 now. Here's Phillips between the circles, back to Beauchamp. Team in Sisley trying to go pick and roll, but nothing there. This man-to-man defense by Bradley has been so tenacious all afternoon. Nothing's been easy for Evansville. Five to shoot here for Beauchamp. Tries to go around Boya to the basket. Nice move, but he left it short. It's going to be a shot clock violation, and Beauchamp's shot never hit the backboard. Going to take us to our media timeout with 14:08 to play here in the ballgame. Terry Roberts is starting to pick things up here in the second half. 50-24, all Bradley here in Evansville. It's the Valley on ESPN.
Years of being the first in and the last out. 3% year-over-year growth, KPI is looking good. Not bad, Joe.
Well, it's not getting any easier. I'm gonna have to add a new line just to stay competitive.
You know, Joe, replacing that aging equipment would reduce unplanned downtime as well as some unplanned nights and weekends. So, what can I help you with, Joe?
Everything.
Old National Bank. Your success is everything.
The University of Evansville's Master of Science in Leadership is a flexible online program that cultivates innovation, creativity, and visionary initiative. This accelerated degree offers personal advising from UE faculty and industry professionals, providing the tools you need to grow as a professional, learn the most effective communication management techniques, team building strategies, and more for a competitive edge in any industry. Apply today. You can start your degree in any semester. Take your career to the next level through UE's Master of Science in Leadership program.
Since 1907, we've been one Valley, breaking down recruitment barriers, hiring coaches to lead our programs, and developing the country's next set of leaders. MVC student athletes are positively impacting the communities where they live by sharing views and fostering a climate for change for future Valley pioneers. To learn more about mobilizing voices for change, visit nvc-sports.com/onevalley.
DoubleTree by Hilton Evansville is located in the heart of downtown Evansville within walking distance to many eating, shopping, and entertainment options. Our exemplary service starts with a warm chocolate chip cookie at check-in. Settle in to a beautiful king or queen guest room with HDTV, mini fridge, coffee maker, free Wi-Fi, and much more. Enjoy delicious meals at the Stone City Grill and local beers at the Quarry Bar. Our state-of-the-art business center is perfect for conferences and celebrations. DoubleTree by Hilton Evansville, a preferred partner of the Missouri Valley Conference.
The Valley on ESPN is brought to you by Cytex, the image makers. Old National Bank, your bank for life. The DoubleTree by Hilton in downtown Evansville. State Farm, and a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And the Missouri Valley Conference, the Valley runs deep.
Great in Bradley history, Missouri Valley history. Hersey Hawkins, the Bradley faithful, they've traveled from Peoria, credit to them, but for Hersey Hawkins, just joining the National Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame back in November, the all-time leading scorer in Bradley MVC history, 10th nationally in the NCAA record book, 3,000 career points. Not only that, he also had a pretty good NBA career as well.
A sixth overall pick back in 1988. Hersey Hawkins, Bradley legend, and Bradley, a phenomenal game played so far here this afternoon, a 26-point lead here over Evansville. And Jason Kent back in the ball game with some foul trouble and a big jump shot right there, making a 28-point Bradley advantage. 52-24. A foul call below the basket as Beauchamp hits the deck. It's going to be against the big man Boya, and indeed it will be. And the most staggering fact about the stat fact, whatever you want to say about this game, Evansville just 8 of 34 from the field, 23.5%. We've said it numerous times, they've had some good looks beyond the arc or inside, but just cannot get that ball to fall through the net.
And most of those good looks especially came in the first half. I feel like in the second half, those good looks have kind of been few and far in between a little bit more.
Gibbons gets hit shot blocked by Boya. Second time we've seen Boya fly and send one back, and now Kent gets the ball at the other end.
Hey, what's up? It's hard to characterize it into words, but it's invaluable to have a big man who's athletic and can move like Boya, especially at the mid-major level.
Here's Hickman, the freshman, working against Coleman, his lefty. Layup won't fall, and the rebound to Shamar Gibbons for Evansville. Still a 28-point Bradley advantage at 52-24, and Evansville trying to cut that one down to 13 to play. Coleman left wing three. That one's an air ball. That kind of describes how this game's gone for Evansville today. At the other end, here's Howell. Left open for a three-point shot. That time was Tavanian. And the Bradley lead continues to extend, now a 31-point Brave advantage. It's been all Braves in this one. 15 to shoot here for the Purple Aces. Sisley down low, working against Boya. Nice cut by Coleman, and his layup up a good. And that's one thing I think, Preston, that Evansville has lacked. We haven't seen a lot of, you know, cuts towards the basket. A lot of moving without the basketball, I guess you could say. And Evansville has settled for a lot of outside shots.
Yeah, and then the few times that they've been able to get to the basket, their shot's been blocked or they missed it. I mean, their shooting percentage shows that.
Speaking of backdoor cuts, nobody guarded Jason Kent with a two-handed flush. It just seems like Bradley has just not even been phased. I mean, it really... Early on, you mentioned the 10-9 Evansville lead, and that was just when things were getting going. But since that run started for Bradley, it's been no looking back, as Frederick King's fadeaway jumper won't fall either.
And that just shows the difference between, one, a team with confidence, you know, and winning games, but also just playing in rhythm. There's not been many times where Bradley has just looked out of sorts on either end of the floor.
You mentioned this team finding its groove at the right time. Bradley right in the middle of the MVC standings. It's the right time to get hot, that's for sure. Hickman left wing three won't fall. A rare miss from the Braves, especially in the second half. Gibbons the other way. Coleman will try a right wing three. That one's good. Eight points for Evan Coleman, and a timeout on the floor. This will be a full timeout. 57-29 Bradley. There's that dunk from Jason Kent, who's been doing it all for the Braves today.
Bringing home the Batman Calzone from Little Caesars might make you feel like Batman. But could you really be the Batman? Never mind. But at least the new Batman Calzone with a calzone crust will make you feel like you're a superhero. The Batman, in theaters March 4th.
Pizza, pizza.
Getting your paycheck up to 2 days earlier is another reason banking with Capital One is an even easier decision than this.
Which one are you going to open up first?
That one!
No way!
Yep, even easier than that. What's in your wallet?
At Lowe's, you never have to be finished with your finishing touches, with aisles of ways to refresh and restyle for whatever style you're feeling. At prices you're really feeling. Shop the Lowe's Bath Style and Save event now, in-store and online.
3 days in a row, huh?
I know, right?
Let's do this.
It's like an album drop at home.
Peloton, let's get hyped for the weekend. Shoulders on fire.
It's a secret to my superhuman muscle strength.
It's my focus, my center, my lunch break.
Take my breath. Woo! I am making it last forever, babe. Do it now or never, babe. Take my breath.
Engaged, but not sure what to do next? Plan your whole wedding at Zola. Start with venues and vendors near you. We'll find ones that fit your style and budget. Get all of your guests' addresses with Superlink. Send it out and watch your guest list fill up in a flash. Then explore Save the Dates. Enjoy free personalized samples and free addressing too. Add a free matching website to keep guests updated and build a registry that lives right there. Fill it with gifts, experiences, even cash funds. Get started for free at Zola.com.
Halftime, or not halftime, second half here in Evansville, 57-29, Bradley all over the Purple Aces this afternoon. And don't forget, download the Arch Madness app presented by Great Southern Bank as the official app for the 2022 State Farm NBC Men's Basketball Tournament. The app has all the information you need to plan your trip to St. Louis, including the tournament schedule, tickets, hotel accommodations, and special events during March Madness. Log on to archmadness.com or download the Arch Madness app on your Android or iOS device today. Again, that's the Arch Madness app presented by Great Southern Bank. There's the couple of big games coming up in the Valley over the next couple of days, but this one is tonight. UNI and Drake on ESPNU at 5 o'clock, and then Indiana State and Valparaiso later on this evening, as well as SIU and Illinois State. Those last two games can be seen on ESPN+.
Some conference in-state rivalries on the docket for today, and that UNI Drake, oh, it looks so tasty to watch between the Panthers and the Bulldogs. Coach DeVries, Coach Jacobson, they're going to have their teams ready to play on ESPNU.
Lots of games to keep your eye on over the next couple of weeks with, as we mentioned, the Arch Madness tournament month from today when that's going to be going on in St. Louis. Beauchamp will fire a hesitation three and another miss for Evansville. Make that 10 of 40 from the field for the Purple Aces, 5 of 18 from beyond the three-point line. Tell you what, Preston, been very impressed with what I've seen from this Bradley team this afternoon, and we always talk about when you get to St. Louis, it's anybody's contest. Is going to be a corner three from Roberts that won't fall, and Kent will keep it alive, but it's anybody's game in St. Louis, and there's no question the Braves have a chance to make a run and win the whole thing.
Yeah, that's exactly right. They are for sure a contender for at least a Saturday semifinal spot, but if they get the right draw and the matchups line up right, I wouldn't be surprised to see them on that championship Sunday for the title on the line. Again, they won back-to-back 19-20. They're in a good spot, the Bradley Braves.
It's going to take us to a timeout where Bradley again leads Evansville 57-29. We'll step aside. It's the Valley on ESPN.
America's been thunderstruck by the all-new 2022 Mitsubishi Outlander. With a sleek exterior and premium interior, get high style without the high price during the spring sales event. Get thunderstruck.
If you're always asking, where next? Capital One has a new class of travel card for you. Venture X. Earn 10x miles on hotels and 5x miles on flights booked through Capital One Travel. Venture X. What's in your wallet?
Arby's. 2 for $6. Every day, two beefs,
two cheddars together. Two of those things for just $6. Arby's, we have the meat.
Do business differently. Find yourself out in front. Because when you're trusted to lead and there is no blueprint, you lead. Others might be surprised to see you there, but we're not. Wisconsin School of Business at UW-Madison, the next generation of leaders.
Vivid Seats, your ticket to ninth inning nail biters, third period penalty kills, fourth quarter buzzer beaters, and 57-yard game winners. Buy tickets, earn rewards with Vivid Seats. Life happens live.
See the league's stars shine in Las Vegas. The NFL Pro Bowl in Las Vegas, presented by Verizon. Tomorrow at 3 Eastern on ABC and ESPN.
It's over 9 minutes to go here in Evansville. 57-29, Bradley in front. The Braves are... we've got all cylinders. We're about a month away from the NBC tournament in St. Louis. Arch Madness, always a great time of the year. You're late, so we get close to the postseason.
A couple UE basketball alums in attendance. You just saw a picture there. Adam Wing, part of the 2015 CIT championship team here in Evansville.
That was a fun team. DJ Ballantyne, couple of names like that.
Yeah, Gideus Moskevicius.
Yeah, oh yeah. It's always a tough one. Here's a right corner three for Evan Coleman. That's his third three-pointer of the afternoon. It's been a relatively quiet day for everybody wearing the white. 11 points for Evan. For places back within 25 at 57-32. If you're Evansville, you know, you put the scoreboard aside, you still want to see some improvements and positive things from the Purple Aces here in the next couple of weeks, because, you know, they don't want to go into St. Louis and be a one and done. They want to win a game over there at least.
Yeah, and that's the thing, is right now it's pretty much a high percentage chance that they're going to be playing on Thursday based at this point in the season. And so you're going to be looking to at least make things difficult for that team that you might face on Thursday and get to Friday. Of course, always the challenge, especially where Evansville sits in the standings, that they do win the Thursday, they would play the one seed right at noon on Friday. So they would have the quick turnaround, and that's always, I think, a big part of the challenge for some of the Thursday teams, and especially the lower seeds.
Here's Roberts working against Coolman. Tending to shoot here for the Braves. And Roberts seems to be shaken up. He dribbled out and handed it off to Howell and took a tough fall. And with that, we'll go ahead and take a short break. It's the Valley on ESPN.
To say the place is inspiring is a complete understatement.
I've lived here 40 years, and I look at it every day, and it's still totally amazing to me.
That's the stuff that is spine-tingling.
Everything just is a backdrop for inspiration.
Memory after memory, your view of life will change.
Those moments seared into your senses because they were so new.
We have 50 years of students who would tell you, take the chance, embrace the unknown, see what this adventure holds.
4 years of med school, 3 years residency, and two proud parents. Congratulations, you're a physician.
Glad that's over with.
Marriage, kids, work-life balance, taking over my practice.
What?
It's time to start planning for the future.
You know, we're gonna need some help with this.
Your mom and I didn't do it alone.
It's so nice to find the new you. Your dad's
doing Old National. Your success is everything.
Assuming all NBA players want rings. It's like assuming State Farm doesn't have great rates.
Why do we have coasters if nobody's gonna use them?
For surprisingly great rates to fit any budget, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
What lies beyond today? Beyond ourselves?
beyond the fear of the unknown, beyond what we think of as limits. Compelled by curiosity, we look for answers. Fueled by community, we strive further. Whatever lies beyond, we were built to find it. Built by someone who knew that beyond is not a destination, but a lifetime of beginning the journey again and again.
Another UE basketball alum in attendance, Richie Johnson, the former third-round pick to the Detroit Pistons in 1985, part of those solid mid-80s teams for the Purple Aces. So some of the former alums in attendance seeing their program in action here today. Of course, there's many others that attend on the regular here at the Ford Center as well.
Yeah, it's always fun to see those old players. Rather, they've got the headset on across the way or at this table or rather in the stands hanging out. But always fun to see some purple and orange legends in the building here at the Ford Center. But, of course, not the best outing today for the Purple Aces. And here's that injury from Terry Roberts. We saw him go down before that timeout. And, hard to tell exactly what it was. Obviously, a knee or a leg injury. But hopefully that's nothing serious for him. This was a three-point shot there from Tavanainen. Makes it back to a 30-point Bradley lead at 62-32. 7.5 to play in this one. Here's Phillips. Back to Beauchamp left side. Beauchamp's played a lot of minutes in this contest. And only 4 points to show for it. 2 of 9 from the field in Blaise Beauchamp. 10 to shoot here for the Purple Aces. Give it step back three on the right side. Left that one short. Rebound in the hands of Hickman. So we made the point that if Evansville is going to want to win a game in the Arch Madness, they're going to face the one seed. But the question is, who's going to be that one seed? It's kind of a three-way race right now with Loyola and Drake, Missouri State, all three teams there towards the top. Going to make for an exciting final couple of weeks here in the regular season. And, of course, it's always a fun weekend in St. Louis.
And there's, once again, another chance for the Valley to maybe a multi-bid league this year, getting the tournament automatic bid, plus one of those other teams like Drake or Missouri State or Loyola, as you mentioned.
You talk about the teams the Valley is adding. We mentioned a couple of them earlier in the broadcast, Murray State, Illinois, Chicago, and as well as Belmont. Those are teams that are very familiar with playing in the postseason as well. So I think we're going to see for the years to come multiple bids in the tournament from the Valley.
Yeah, just a strong build. I mean, 12 teams in the Valley going forward. It's been 10 for a good chunk the last so long years, and now up to 12. So it's growing in terms of number. It's growing in terms of markets. They got Illinois, Chicago to replace Loyola, as Loyola will be leaving the conference. So they kept the Chicago market. They got the Nashville market now with Belmont. So, again, the Valley just building and getting better in big ways. And, of course, a lot of these fans here in Evansville know exactly what Belmont and Murray State are made of because of the Ohio Valley tournament that's held here at the Ford Center in March, where it seems like it's been on repeat for those two teams to meet up in the championship game.
Murray State, a very talented team this year, undefeated in conference play there in the Ohio Valley. Final 8 to shoot here for the Purple Aces, 62-32 Bradley, as Beauchamp gets to the rack. A nice move by him, but he'll draw the foul. He will shoot a pair of free throws. Not a lot of fouls been called on either side. That is the 8th foul against Bradley, and only 7 on the Evansville side.
You just love it now, because now it's February, a month away from all the championships. You start kind of wringing your head, okay, who wins the Valley? You know, who's going to be maybe those multi-bids? Then you think of the big picture nationally. You know, who's going to be the Final Four teams? I mean, there's some good teams. Today's a great slate of college basketball nationally. Baylor and Kansas, 8-10 in the top 10 facing off. Of course, the classic rivalry of Duke, North Carolina later tonight as well. So it's a big day for college basketball.
How can you not enjoy this time of year? I just don't know it. Super Bowl here next weekend.
If it was a little bit warmer, I'd be thrilled.
No kidding.
But in terms of basketball,
not quite there yet. Maybe
totally
a couple months for that. 62-34, 28-point Bradley advantage. Final 6 minutes in this one. Braves are on their way to win their 13th game of the season. Nice drive there by Howe. He'll turn and fade, and that one won't go. But boy, able to keep it alive again, and that three-point shot there from Tavanayad won't fall. Evansville shooting 25.5% from the field this afternoon, 11 for 43. Kind of the same problem they ran into the first time they played the Braves up in Peoria. Just unable to hit shots. Looking against Boya, that shot up and off the mark was Anaruna, who will go to the free throw line. It's the fourth foul on Boya, so he's got four, and Hickman has four. A couple of players in foul trouble for Bradley.
And that's the second time in this game where Anaruna has gotten into the game, where he provides an inside post presence. You know, when Kuhlman's in the game, he'll step outside. Sicily's kind of a mix of, I guess, of both sides of the basketball, because he will step out and shoot it, but also play inside. Anaruna, though, you saw some good footwork, and that's the second time in this game where he's kind of bodied up Boya to get to the free throw line.
Second free throw for Anaruna off the mark. Goes 0 for 2. 62-34, Bradley, 5 minutes to go in this one. Yeah, you might want to start seeing Brian Wardle and his squad just start to kill that shot clock. Got to give your props to Bradley with the way they played in the second half. Still is the missed dunk attempt, but there's Boya with the put back in two. But, you know, the way that Bradley, you know, never really backed down at any point in this game. You know, they made that run there in the first half, big halftime lead, but never at one point did they give Evansville really a chance to make a comeback.
I mean, and that's the thing that is also stands out in the way you're saying is basically, are they about to play a full 40 minutes that coaches always hear about? Probably not. I'm sure there's some things that the coaches are going to go into the film and say, hey, we've got to get better in this area before tourney time.
That's a three-point shot from Zach Montgomery on the left top. And when it rains, it pours as the run continues here for Bradley.
But usually when a team has such a big lead, there's sometimes, you know, you let the foot off the gas a little bit. You have a little bit of a letdown, a little bit of a drought. They've not had that.
Yep. Beauchamp left corner, three won't fall. Montgomery the rebound. Under four to play in this one. If you're Evansville, couple of bright spots here and there. I mean, offensively, obviously the shots didn't go in, but you had some good looks. Defensively, you can't really guard that. And that's kind of describes how this game has gone for Bradley as Tavanina hits another three.
Again, I'm trying to check. Looks like he's wearing 23. There's just something about that number, that I guess has magical abilities to shoot the basketball and score points.
Tavanina's got 12 points today. Is going to be a couple of free throws there as Antoine Smith Jr. gets to the basket, but that will take us to our under four media timeout.
Bringing home the Batman Calzone from Little Caesars might make you feel like Batman, but could you really be the Batman? Never mind. But at least the new Batman Calzone with a calzone crust will make you feel like you're a superhero. The Batman, in theaters March 4th. Pizza, pizza.
Hi. Good afternoon. Great, how are you?
Find the silver lining in flight delays. Vacation starts at the airport. With Centurion Lounge Access, one of the many reasons you're with Amex Platinum.
When your business is on its A game, the only competition it has is itself.
As an autonomous digital enterprise, you automate the mundane to focus on innovation. Become an autonomous digital enterprise with BMC.
If that particular play doesn't happen, I don't know what happens with my career beyond that.
3:22 left in this one, 70-34 Bradley, and what's been a fantastic afternoon for the Braves. And you see their upcoming schedule. They have to play this. They want to get through this tough schedule coming up. They're going to be at home against Loyola Chicago on the 9th, and they're taking on Drake at home at SIU, home against the Redbirds of Illinois State, then at Missouri State. And Evansville coming up, doubleheader with Indiana State on the 8th and 10th, at SIU, at Drake, and then at home against Valpo. That game is a makeup from earlier in this week. They got snowed out due to the weather here in Evansville. First free throw for Antoine Smith is up and good.
As part of that makeup, they'll play Valpo home, get the day off in between. They'll travel to Valpo, get another day off, and then they'll play at Loyola. So it's going to be kind of a hectic schedule for the Aces, especially, again, we mentioned the two games back-to-back against Indiana State, another makeup scenario there. And I believe it's going to be 9 games in 21 days for the Evansville Aces.
See, a lot of teams have to do schedule adjustments like that, of course, due to COVID-19, but some weather-related stuff, you know, here as we're into the winter months, but you're right, going to be a hectic final last 3 weeks for the Purple Aces as we head into tournament play. Darius Hanna will shoot a couple of free throws here for Bradley, his first minutes of the afternoon, and first one's up and good. You know, the 6'9 sophomore from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, goes 1 of 2. Well, if you're both teams, a couple of players, reserves in the ballgame, want to see some bright spots for the weeks to come. There's some guys that don't get normally as many minutes. Here's a Met Page with a basketball for Evansville, going to be an and one.
Basket is good.
Nice drive by Page, the junior. Could be a chance for an old-fashioned three-point play. Page is averaging 1 point per game and about 5 minutes per game this year, and trying to earn some more minutes as he hits the old-fashioned three-point play, 71-39 Bradley. After 3 minutes left to play in this one. And it's still there by Page at the other end. Gets a loose ball, and got his shot deflected, and Bradley maintains possession. It will be exciting. I mentioned those games coming up for Bradley against Loyola and against Drake, and we talked about as the offensive foul call there against Montgomery, but talking about how Bradley can fare in the top half of the NBC. They're really going to get a taste of how it's going to be in those next two games against Loyola and Drake.
Yeah, it's going to be big time, and it'll be the true test, especially down the stretch, you know, as a measuring stick for these Braves. You know, how do they stack up against the top teams, against the best in the Valley? Well, they'll quickly find out with that slate they have up ahead. Of course, Loyola, they have a big matchup tomorrow against Missouri State on ESPN2. Williamson, Mosley going at it.
Blake Sisley gets the layup right there, just a freshman. A lot of talk around about him. Future, he's got as a Purple Ace. Went to Heritage Hills High School, not too far from here, in Santa Claus, Indiana. Final 140 in this one. 30-point Bradley advantage, 71-41. Pick and roll pass got deflected and taken away by Evansville. That was Preston Phillips who got the steal.
I mean, overall, the Sisley family is just an athletic basketball family. His brother Trent getting some big-time offers. His dad played at the Division I level.
Montgomery left open on a right wing three, and the three-point shot has just been almost automatic for Bradley in this game. Braves 12 of 24 from beyond the arc today.
Yeah, both these teams normally good on average for about 8 threes made per game. Fact of the matter is Bradley has made that and then some. Evansville overall struggling from the field. It's kind of interesting when you dive into the stats, especially now when you get into this part of the season. Obviously, there's enough sample size to take a look at. There's always like a little goal number for each team in terms of points scored, you know, total shots made, three-pointers made, and you can kind of tell if they're going to hit that mark in a certain way, they're going to win the game. If not, then it usually goes in the negative direction.
Final 45 seconds. Bradley just trying to kill as much clock as they can, about a 30-second difference in the shot and game clock. As Max Okono goes to the basket, and he'll shoot a couple of free throws. Okono, the 6'7 freshman from France. Couple of international players on this Bradley roster. Now Tavanainen from Finland. Mass, of course, from the Netherlands. Leons from the Netherlands as well.
Bradley has a strong history of getting some international flavor to their roster over the years. And credit to them and their recruiting process to find that talent overseas and in foreign countries. Not just sticking around to the Midwest pipeline, they're going broader than that.
Step back three for Page, left that one short. Probably the last shot Evansville will shoot. And this one with the shot clock turned off, final 20.1 seconds. And Bradley is gonna walk out of the Ford Center with a monstrous 35-point win today. Braves are gonna improve to 13-11 on the season. They'll go to 7-5 in the Valley. Meanwhile, Evansville drops to 5-16. An illustrious 1-9 record in the NBC. Final score, Bradley 76, Evansville 41. It was all Braves from the get-go. And a big win for the Braves. Again, their 13th win on the season, 13-11. They try to climb back up in those NBC standings. They're right in the middle, and a couple of big games coming up for them in the next couple of weeks. Cole Carter, Preston Linebach, and Preston. I kind of said it was from the get-go, it was all Bradley in this one.
All Bradley. It was close for a little bit. Remember, that 10-9 mark for Evansville. But again, the offense went cold. Bradley takes advantage. They hit their shots. They spread the ball around. Unselfish play from the Braves. We were talking about Roberts and Mass at the beginning of the game. It was other guys who stepped up today for the Bradley Braves.
Especially Jason Kent, one of those guys. And we see the stats from this game. We'll talk about Kent in a minute, but man, that shooting percentage, 50% from the field were the Braves. Evansville just 27.1% at a 13-for-48 mark, and that three-point shooting, 12-of-24 for the Braves.
Yeah, efficient overall from three, dominating on the glass, and of course, once again, just getting the assists and that assist to turnover ratio, just a good number for the Braves here today.
Leading scorer for Bradley was Jason Kent. He had 14 points, 6-of-8 from the field. Had some foul trouble early in the second half, but it didn't matter. He was consistent as you can be for the Braves today.
Yeah, he was kind of all over the place, and he moved himself to be in a good spot to receive the basketball and score. I mean, you look at that jump shot, so pure. I mean, like I said, the release is at the top, it's at the peak. And that's why he finishes as today's player in the game with 14 points for Bradley.
Mentioned how Bradley's going to fare in the next couple of weeks. They're trying to make their way up in these Valley standings. See them at number 5 and 4 very good teams in front of them. They're going to play two of them. Loyola and Drake are the next two games on their schedule. But, I mean, Preston, just so many good basketball teams in this Missouri Valley Conference.
So many good teams, a lot of experience. And there's a big difference in a way in terms of one game can make the difference between being first right now or being fifth for Bradley. And right now they have that fifth spot. So it's going to be a lot of fun down the final month of the Valley season.
Again, the NBC tournament will be in St. Louis the first weekend of March, about a month away from now. Well, that's going to do it for our broadcast this afternoon. Special thanks to executive producer Jordan Alves, director Edwin Ford Jr., and the entire Purple Aces production crew for bringing the action to you. So for Preston Linebach, I'm Cole Carter saying so long from Evansville, Indiana, where the final score was Bradley 76, Evansville 41. All games airing on the ESPN Network are streaming live and archived on the ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN.